Welcome to another Tuesday's Tales. The conservation movement is a movement that seeks to manage natural resources as well as their habitat for the future. In support of the new conservation movement in the United States, Eliza Skidmore wrote a letter to the editor of the Century magazine in September 1893 on our new national forest reserves, detailing the meaning and consequences of forest preservation on behalf of the public good. But who was Eliza Skidmore? The year was 1885. In a time where many women were staying at home, Mrs. Eliza Rumaha Skidmore was a world traveler, writer, and diplomat. After a trip to Japan, she proposed that Japanese cherry trees be planted along the Potomac River, but nobody would listen to her. For the next 24 years, she continued on her mission with no success. Finally, in 1906, Dr. David Fairchild, a plant explorer and U.S. Department of Agricultural official, tested the ability of cherry trees to thrive near Washington, D.C. by planting them on his own property in Chevy Chase, Maryland. 1 year later, the experiment was deemed a success. Then, he gave cherry tree saplings to children in D.C. schools to plant in their schoolyard for Arbor Day. Eliza Skidmore wanted to raise money to buy the cherry trees and donate them to the city, so she wrote a note to the new First Lady, Helen Taft. Now, Mrs. Taft had lived in Japan and knew how beautiful the flowering cherry trees were, and 2 days later, she replied with a note. Tokyo's mayor agreed to send the gift of cherry trees to Washington, D.C., and the First Lady agreed to accept a donation of 2,000 cherry trees. They arrived the next year in 1910, but sadly they were infested with pests and had to be destroyed. Then, Tokyo's mayor and others suggested a second donation be made. This time, they would send 3,020 cherry trees. On February 14th, 1912, they were sent to Washington, D.C. And on March 27th, 1912, First Lady Helen Taft and the Viscountess Chinda, wife of the Japanese ambassador, planted 2 Yoshino cherry trees on the northern bank of the tidal basin. The National Cherry Blossom Festival in Washington, D.C. started from this simple ceremony. And those 2 original trees still stand several hundred yards west of the John Paul Jones Memorial. And that is the story of how the Japanese cherry blossoms came to Washington, D.C. The festival is celebrated through the National Park Service, who was also ultimately responsible for Piscataway Park, the sacred homeland of the Piscataway people that the Akakik Foundation stewards.